If you're familiar with the name Sylvia Browne or Walter Mercado, then you will love my guest today. So if you're looking for direction or searching for guidance or ready for the truth, then stay tuned and let VEE show you how to unlock the power you already have within you.
No more waiting, anticipating, or hesitating. Now is the time.
Welcome to the Orgena Rose Show.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the show. My guest today is a channel who discovered her natural gifts when she attended a workshop that was discussing the book, The Celestine Prophecy. So she and her over 1,300 guides provide you with the tools to truly empower your life. Welcome to the show, VEE.
So welcome, VEE.
Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, it is my pleasure, truly, truly, to have you. Thank you for being here. So, it's quite a journey you've had from that workshop discussing a book,
yes,
to over 1,300 guides. So,
yes.
So kind of let's go back to that workshop. What happened, and, you know, share with everyone, what happened for you that let you know something was happening? Something
well, there was a group of people about the Celestine Prophecy with the workshop.
Okay.
And so we were asked to hide our backs or, like, you know, write down things that we thought were good about the people.
Okay.
And I thought, I have no idea who these people are. So they're nice, they're kind, whatever. And then what I started doing is I started seeing a vision. So with one woman I said, I see you in Native American garb, I see pine trees, and I see you gathering herbs. She turns around and she says, I am Native American, I have pine trees in my backyard, and I have an herb garden. That freaked me out.
Okay, I love that you said that, because
yes,
I think for a lot of people, that really is a reaction. That is the initial reaction, like, oh my God, like the OMG moment, right?
Absolutely.
So you had that.
Yeah, and several times. So then the woman who was in charge of the Celestine Prophecy workshop, she said, we need to talk. And I'm like, about what? And she says, you're psychic. I'm like, come again.
Right.
So she started telling me about her gifts. I was like, oh my gosh, these are mine too. And that's what this is called. So I would write them all down because I never knew what what I was doing was.
So you were having experiences already?
Yes, since I was four.
Ah, four. So what happened at four?
When we passed graveyards, I would wave and say hello. So that was kind of strange.
I love it. Whoa. You would wave and
but I didn't remember until my sister reminded me that I did that.
So were you seeing?
Yes.
Seeing?
Yes.
Being.
In the graveyards, because those were that's where their graves were. So that's what I saw.
So you were waving to the folks in the grave.
Yes.
So then what happened after that? Like at 5, 6, 7, 8, did other occurrences happen for you?
No, not really. I shut down for a couple of decades. So what happened was,
wow,
I didn't feel I was able to open myself up.
Okay.
So I would study movies,
okay,
such as Sybil, such as Three Faces of Eve.
Wow.
I read books,
mm-hmm,
trying to figure out what was going on, because
okay,
I kept hearing voices, and the voices I heard were male.
Ah, okay.
So then one day, just like the scene in Dr. Doolittle, Eddie Murphy's version, when
yes,
he was taken to the mental institution, I had actually cried.
Wow.
So in between that, I had gone to one myself. That's why I could relate.
Really?
I had packed my bags, I had dressed up in a business suit, and I said, I'm crazy. And the doctor said, I deal with people who've forgotten how to tie their shoes. You dressed yourself.
Right.
So you're okay.
Yeah.
And I was like, no, I'm not.
Wow.
So a few years later,
mm-hmm,
I went to the Celestine Prophecy workshop,
mm-hmm,
where a psychic was running it, and she started telling me, okay, you're psychic. I'm like, you're crazy.
Oh, wow. So hold that thought right there. We'll be back.
What truly sets you apart from your competition? Do you know the answer? Most business owners don't, and the truth is, it's what can make or break your business. Every business wants it, but few know how to get it, and that is instant recognition. The kind you get when you hear a slogan, some piece of music, or even see a logo that brings a specific brand to mind. Many businesses and organizations spend a great deal of time and energy on the visual and forget the audio. Just like you would never send out a print piece without your logo on it, we recommend all your audio should be branded with an audio logo. Nobody does it like Severly. Not only are they great for instant recognition, but they have a long shelf life. Some jingles last decades and even lifetimes.
Wow, that's a lot. Let's unpack that a little bit, because so what shut you down at the 4-year-old? Like, was there some internal thing, or did someone say something to you, or you just got a sense that's not okay?
I got a sense it was not okay. I didn't have a family that was exactly embracing something like that.
Sure.
So I really had no one I could talk to about it.
Okay. And so you felt probably a little isolated.
Not a little.
A lot.
Yeah, exactly.
So a couple of decades go by. So
yes.
You're now in your 20s,
mm-hmm.
and you check yourself in?
Yes.
Because you're hearing voices.
Yes.
And you're thinking you're crazy.
Exactly.
Wow.
I also had thoughts of not wanting to be on this planet anymore.
Right.
Because I was imploding.
Wow.
So it was affecting every aspect of my life.
Mm-hmm.
So I wasn't doing very well with jobs. You know, I was
right.
okay in school, but I could have been better.
Right.
So I was like, I'm crazy. This has to be it.
And it was the voices that were really, I mean, it could be difficult to think, right? Just be able to focus on something.
It was one voice.
Ah, okay.
And then as I got older, they became several.
Wow.
So yeah, it was one voice.
And were they distinctive?
Yes, very.
Interesting. And what kinds of things were they saying?
Well, they would say, for example, when I was at my low point, I wanted to say goodbye to the world.
Sure.
I had planned it.
Of course. Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This was.
Mm-hmm. So I was in my living room okay. in the fetal position, and I said, I'm ready. And so I heard a voice like, well, what about your apartment? Because I was a mess.
I love it.
Yeah,
okay.
It looked like Sanford and Son. It was so bad. And so then I was like, I'm good if they find me in a mess. And
uh-huh.
then the one question that saved my life was, who's going to take care of your cat?
Wow. It's the people or the pets or the things that we love that we would leave behind that usually does it.
And my cat saved my life.
Wow. That's powerful. That's powerful. So I want to come back to, okay, you've checked yourself in.
Yes.
Or you actually stayed.
No, they said.
They said, no, you're not crazy.
Exactly.
Even though you're telling them, I hear voices, I can't function, I'm ready to check out, like
yeah.
all of that, and they still didn't keep you.
They left me with a bottle of very nice Prozac. Loved it. 2 weeks of joy. It was great. And then I was like, okay, what
now
is
what?
This?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when we come back, we're going to find out what were your next steps to try to understand what is going on with you, because I have a feeling so many of you may be experiencing similar things or one or two of these things, and I really want you to be able to share
absolutely
what those next steps were for you.
Yep,
so
I'd be happy to.
Make sure you come back right after this.
Tired of giving the same old gifts of flowers, chocolates, perfume, or cologne? Finding it hard to come up with that perfect and special gift? Want to put your love into words? How about putting it to music? Capture the magic of your love in your very own love song. Imagine your unique love story told in an intensely powerful and emotional way through the magic of music. Give a gift that is truly one of a kind and absolutely priceless. Get your custom signature song at CustomSignatureSongs.com or by calling 323-238-4653. That's 323-238-4653.
Rest in love.
And we're back with V, who is sharing with us her experiences from the age of 4 in hearing voices, seeing dead people, and what her next steps were. So, V, they don't accept you. Mm-hmm. You're trying to check yourself in to the mental institution. They will not take you. What do you do?
Well, they gave me some really nice Prozac pills, and for 2 weeks I was a very happy child.
Very happy. Okay.
So throughout all of this, I used to call psychics. Remember Dionne Warwick's psychic
mind
thing? Because I thought psychics could control the future. So since I didn't have control of the present, I thought they can control the future and tell me.
Okay.
So I spent, unfortunately, an embarrassingly large amount of money trying to do that. And then I was talking to a coworker of mine, and she brought to my attention about this woman who was a psychic locally. And I was thrilled. I could see a psychic face to face.
Right.
And that's when she did a reading for me. I cried. She cried. And then she said, I'd like for you to be part of the Celestine Prophecy workshop I'm beginning.
Ah, okay. So that's how you actually got to the workshop.
Yes.
You were invited.
Yes.
Because you had already spoken to a psychic.
Yes.
And she could see your gifts.
Yes. Okay. But I didn't know I had gifts.
You didn't know they were gifts.
None at all.
And you didn't experience them as a gift necessarily.
No, not at all.
Okay. And I'm curious, the voices or the messages you were hearing, were they about other people, for other people, about yourself, about situations you were in? What were they?
They were always about other people.
Okay.
So it started out in dream state, and I learned that in dream state, that's your safest place.
Mm.
So you can have prophetic dreams.
Yes.
And then I would have the dreams, remember them, and then they came true.
Ah.
So it freaked me out a little bit.
I so
yes.
understand that. That happened actually for me at 9 years old.
Oh,
was
wow.
the first time. And I was over for a weekend with friends, you know, doing a sleepover. And we were playing Barbies and all of that. And we, you know, went to sleep. And I woke up the next morning. We're sitting at the breakfast table at her house. And I'm telling everyone, oh my goodness, I had this dream last night. And it was about Eric Estrada. And he had a motorcycle accident.
Oh.
And I'm giving great detail. Before I could hardly finish the sentence, breaking news, breaking news. This just in, Eric Estrada had a motorcycle accident last night at blah, blah, blah time, and all the details that I literally just gave them.
Wow.
And so, of course, everyone is literally turning their head, looking at me like, what are you? What planet are you from? What's wrong with you?
Right.
And no one said anything. It was kind of like, let's pretend none of that just happened. Pass the salt, you know, it was kind of one of those things. And everyone, no one spoke about it. It was just, it didn't happen.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, that's exactly the message that I received. This is not okay. You need to shut it down. And that's what I did.
Mm-hmm.
So I love that you had a similar experience, because I think a lot of people may have that very same experience.
Mm-hmm.
So what then did you do, or how was it that you were opened again to it?
I found that when I shared with people my dreams, it was a lot easier than when I saw visions, which is when you're awake.
Yes.
So my dreams started becoming visions.
Okay.
And every time I would get more and more detail of these visions.
Mm-hmm.
And so I would only share it as a dream, because it was safer that way.
Yes, yes. I had a dream about you last
exactly.
night, right? Yeah,
exactly.
Okay.
And then those started coming true. So the vision started coming true.
Okay.
So when I met with this psychic to get a reading, that's when she invited me to the Celestine Prophecy Group.
Okay.
And that's when I was really able to open myself up.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you could see that it was a safe environment. Because, and let's talk a little bit about that, because I think what may be the case for a lot of people is the fear that somehow this is evil, or that this is, they're getting, you know, it's dark energy and dark forces and all of that. So can you help folks who may be worried or afraid that, you know, there's something evil or bad coming through?
It is not evil. It is not bad. It is your gift.
Mm.
And you deserve to embrace that gift. You deserve to support that gift. You deserve to celebrate that gift. And most importantly, you deserve to use that gift. It is your purpose. And it's really important that you are aware of that. So if you don't have a person who's there, who will hear you, who will accept you as you are, do whatever you can to find that person who will do that for you.
Wow. That is so powerful. I think you just helped free a lot of people. And how do you help people who, thank you, who may be, isn't that fabulous, right?
I love it.
who may have grown up in the church and have heard messages that that's all somehow of the devil and all of that.
As an African American woman, I have several titles. I have psychic, I have minister, I have life consultant, and I have business consultant. Mm. So one day I asked my guides, why the freak you give me all these titles? And they said, because you are, as an umbrella, a messenger.
Yes.
And as a messenger, some people can hear and relate as you being a minister, some people can hear and relate as you being a consultant.
Yes.
So it's still the same message.
Right.
No matter what. So it's really important that I have these titles to
yes.
support people
yes.
so they can hear the message in the way they're used to. As an African-American woman in black churches,
yes.
you're not embraced. However, if you're in the church, you're a prophetess.
Thank you. Yes, I was just about to say, they can accept prophetess.
Yes.
Yeah.
However, if you do and say the same thing in a restaurant,
not
you're
so
of the
much.
Devil.
Right. Yeah.
So it really does depend on the environment.
So that's really brilliant. I love that. And I have a lot of colleagues and friends who have similar gifts, and they have had to sort of, you know, maneuver in the same way, where it's, okay, I'm in the business sphere, and so I can't call myself, you know, a prophet or those sorts of things, so I'm an intuitive.
Yeah.
A business intuitive, right? Or there may be medical intuitives.
Yes.
So there's just different words and phrases that are more accepted in different environments, but it's still the same. You're a messenger.
Absolutely.
I love that. I love that. So we're going to, when we come back, find out how you can really tap in, if you don't already know, which I think many of you watching would already really be able to resonate with this, but to be able to know if you are, and then how to really flourish in your gift. We'll do that when we come right back.
What truly sets you apart from your competition? Do you know the answer? Most business owners don't, and the truth is, it's what can make or break your business. Every business wants it, but few know how to get it, and that is instant recognition. The kind you get when you hear a slogan, some piece of music, or even see a logo that brings a specific brand to mind. Many businesses and organizations spend a great deal of time and energy on the visual and forget the audio. Just like you would never send out a print piece without your logo on it, we recommend all your audio should be branded with an audio logo. Nobody does it like Severly. Not only are they great for instant recognition, but they have a long shelf life. Some jingles last decades and even lifetimes.
And we're back with V, who is sharing with us her gifts and how you can tap in and understand yours. So V, you've shared a lot
yes.
that can really help, I think, a lot of people who are having their own experiences but not knowing how and what to do with them. So what would you say are kind of the first steps that you did to learn how to use your gifts and work with them so that they could support you and the life of others rather than
I know, it was awesome.
Be a frill.
Yeah. Hummingbird, yes?
Yes.
They follow me everywhere.
Yes.
Literally follow me everywhere.
I mean, that one, I hope that shot got that. That was really spectacular.
Yeah, it was really cool.
Oh, they show up a lot as well. I love the visit that we just got from this beautiful hummingbird, literally just in the center of us, as I'm discussing how can people really show up in their gifts. What did you do, and what would you suggest people do?
The first thing you want to do is you want to listen to your first voice. Mm. Oftentimes we listen to our second, our third, our 85th
yes,
voice.
That's what I say all the time, first voice, best voice.
And it's very, very quiet. It's a whisper. So as you get more confident, that whisper becomes a normal speaking voice.
Yes.
In my case, sometimes it's yelling and shouting. The second thing you want to do is honor that voice. Mm-hmm. Whatever action you're asked to do,
yes.
do the action. No matter how ridiculous it may seem to you.
Yes.
The third is to realize that your purpose is to help others. Mm-hmm. So if you're guided to do something for someone else,
you do it without question. I do question still.
Yes.
However, I still do it no matter what.
Yeah.
I will call my guides out and say, yes, are you freaking kidding me? You really want me to do this?
Yes.
So I fuss.
Yes.
And then I do it anyway.
And I think that's valid. You
yes.
know, we're a divine being in a
yes.
human body and a human experience. So I think it's certainly fine. And
yes.
I have a colleague who, again, with similar gifts, and she has discussions. She says, let's talk about that. Let's explore. You know, so she recognizes it's still a give and take, right? There's still a relationship that's happening with the guides and information that's coming through. But yes, that ultimately it's for you to share, and it's for their good. It's for the highest good of all. So
there is one more thing.
Yes.
Step four is, no matter what you're told, don't assume a reward will happen.
Yes. Oh, that's so good.
A lot of times people expect, well, I've done this, where's my reward?
Right.
The reward is that you honored your purpose.
Mm.
And that's very important.
Speak to that, that it's your purpose.
A purpose is a talent that you have. That purpose can be singing, songwriting.
Yes.
That purpose can be acting. That purpose can be an architect, a florist. It is what brings you joy instantly,
mm-hmm.
where you don't need to prove to anybody anything.
Yeah.
It just makes you feel good inside.
Mm, beautiful. Isn't that a beautiful, simple definition of your purpose?
Mm-hmm.
And if we really could all step into our purpose and mm-hmm. follow that, we would just each find so much more joy and fulfillment.
Absolutely.
And truly serve the planet in the way that we're called to.
Mm-hmm.
So I love those steps. Let's go through them once again. So first, listen to your first voice.
Yes.
Yes.
The second is you want to trust.
Trust.
That voice.
Trust it.
You want to act on that voice.
Mm.
No matter what you're told, trust and do it.
Yes.
And then last, don't expect any rewards. Know that the message, the purpose, whatever you're supposed to be doing, is that reward.
Is the reward. Just operating in your gift,
mm-hmm.
right? In your purpose. Oh my goodness. Such a beautiful, beautiful message today that you have brought to every single one of us.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any final thoughts for anyone who may be struggling right now?
You're not alone. And that's really important to know, you're not alone. As I said before, continue to look for people who will support you.
Mm.
It will take you on your journey in a way that you never even imagined.
Thank you. So V, I too want to just speak to everyone around the fact that I have personally been able to experience one of your readings. And I can tell you, folks, she is the real deal. It was absolutely phenomenal. It was powerful and right on. And in the year since that reading, so many amazing things have happened for me, how my life has changed, and things have shown up that were right in alignment with what she said. So you have a wonderful gift that you'd like to share with everyone, yes?
Yes, absolutely. Anyone who is seeing this, I will give a free 15-minute psychic reading. Just mention the name Orgena and call me at 520-232-1122. I look forward to your call.
And we'll have that number, of course, on our website. And absolutely take her up on it. She really is amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
And thank all of you for being with us as well. We'll see you next time. Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for being with us today on our show. I really hope that there was something shared that really helps you shine your biggest and brightest light. Please stop by again, like us on Facebook, tweet us, all of those good things. And most importantly, please always remember, it's all about love.
Waiting, anticipating, or hesitating. Now is the time.